Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. Myself Roopesh Jadhav. Today we are going to see the next topic of the climate of India, that is regarding southwest monsoon. Earlier I have explained you about the winter season and also the summer season. Okay, if you have not subscribed our channel Wisdom Jobs, kindly subscribe us. Okay, so subscribe the Wisdom Jobs channel so that you should get the videos update. Okay, and also if you have not visited my previous video, please visit. Okay, so there are location of India, then physiographic division of India, then Northern Indian Plain, then Peninsular Plateau, then Himalayan Range, then islands. All videos till now we have completed, and in coming time I'm going to tell you all the topics I'm going to cover in my upcoming times. Okay, so let's start. So our next season is southwest monsoon season. Okay, so you can see that I have mentioned here southwest monsoon season, and itself it is called as rainy season. Okay, so southwest monsoon season or rainy season, the duration of this season is from June to September. Now before starting for this, we should understand the position of sun, where is the sun right now. Okay, as I have explained you earlier that sun will be here on 21st March. Okay, then it is moving towards the Tropic of Cancer and it will be here on 21st June. Okay, so by then sun is moving towards the Tropic of Cancer, or it will be over the Tropic of Cancer by 21st June. Okay, now coming back, now what is monsoon? The word, it is derived from the word mausim, that is an Arabic word, or mausam, okay, which means season, or another word that is Malayan word, it is monism, which also means the season. So season, it means for the climate which is prevailing for 3 to 4 months or 2-3 months, that is that we called as season. Okay, now exactly what is the definition of monsoon, that is the question. So it means reversal of wind direction, wind and its direction. Okay, if you have seen my previous video, I have explained you about the sea breezes and land breezes. Okay, so this is sea and this is land. So during daytime, the due to high pressure over the sea part and low pressure over the land part, the breezes starts blowing from sea to land. We called it as sea breezes. Okay, it occurs during daytime, it happens in during daytime, and in night time the reverse is the condition, that is low pressure over the sea and high pressure over the land. So the wind starts blowing from land to sea, that we called as land breezes. Okay, remember, the winds blows from high pressure to low pressure. When I said that sea breezes, it is blowing from sea to land, it simply means that here there is high pressure, okay, and here there is low pressure, that's why the breezes are blowing from sea to land. And when I say the land breezes, which blows during night time, okay, those blows from land to sea. So again, here it is pressure high and here at the night time pressure low. Now this happens in day and night. If we calculate these things throughout the period, in which period there will be more proportion of sea breezes. So obviously the month or the duration which come into your mind, that sea breezes blow during daytime. So the if I am asking it is which season that sea breezes are blowing from sea to land, so obviously the answer will be summer. Okay, and during which time that land breezes blow from land to sea, so obviously I have told you land breezes blow during night time, so it means low temperature, so land breezes will be more in winter season. So it simply means that the direction of winds, earlier which was moving in this direction, now it get completely reversed. Okay, it get completely reversed. Earlier it was blowing from sea to land, now from land to sea in that particular direction. Okay, the direction must be reversal. If the winds are blowing from southwest to northeast, okay, in one season, in another season it should blow from northeast to southwest. Okay, is it clear? So in the same direction, if this is southwest and this is northeast, so it is blowing from southeast, no, sorry, southwest to northeast. And another season, it will blow from northeast to southwest. That is complete reversal of wind direction. Okay. And that is what exactly monsoon is. Okay. Now, what are the characteristics of monsoon? Okay. Again, you have to remember that we are talking about only 3 month span. That is from June to September. Okay. Now, what are the different characteristics of the monsoon? The first one is high heat. During this period, there will be high heat. Okay, why? Again, you have to take into the account the position of sun. Because from March, April, May, there was summer. And still the sun is over Tropic of Cancer on 21st June. Again, it will go down. Okay, so June, July, August, and again it will reach at equator on 23rd September. So from 21st June till 23rd September, there is again, I can say that summer is there. Okay. Now let me tell you before going for the further information, there are only 2 seasons throughout the world. Okay. Depending on the position of sun, from 21st March till 23rd September, there is summer in Northern Hemisphere. Okay, because sun lies in Northern Hemisphere. At the same time, from 21st March to 23rd September, there will be winter in Southern Hemisphere. Okay, so in the same way, when sun goes down, that is from 23rd September till 21st March, there will be summer in Southern Hemisphere. At the same time, that is from 23rd September till 21st March, there will be winter in Northern Hemisphere. Right now, we are experiencing it. Okay, December month, we have winter. Okay, why? After 23rd September, the sun is going in the Southern Hemisphere. Okay, if you have not understood what I said, please stop the video and go back and try to understand. Okay, now, so there will be high heat during this period because sun lies in the Northern Hemisphere from 21st June to 23rd September, and some rainy season is during June to September. Okay. Now, high humidity, as there will be high temperature, okay, along with high humidity, though the temperature during this period, during rainy season, decrease by 5 degree to 8 degree Celsius comparatively that of the summer, but still it is high as sun lies in Northern Hemisphere. So though there is reduction in the temperature, but still it is high. Okay, so, and also along due to the presence of moisture, there will be high humidity, so humidity will be at high level. Then there will be clouding, extensive clouding. You may know about that. In rainy season, the whole sky get clouded. Okay, dark clouds are there. So there are extensive clouding during this season. Several spells. Okay, it is spells. That is the rain in different form. Drizzle to heavy rainfall will be there. From moderate to heavy rain with strong surface winds. So there will be, the surface wind will be very much strong. Okay, and at some places we have heavy rainfall, and at other places there is very low rainfall, inadequate rainfall. So in that way, okay, now why the monsoon comes to this part? Okay, now let me tell you, monsoon is the typical characteristics only of it, confined to certain area like South Asian nations. Okay, so South Asian nation in which India, Myanmar, Indonesia, that part comes. Okay, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. So these monsoon is confined to this typical region only. Okay, now, but along with that, western part of Australia, some part of Japan, China, coastal area. So that also receive rainfall during monsoon season. Now, why these winds comes, or why there is? So what are the pressure condition during rainy season? Okay, firstly, low pressure, try to understand. As sun lies in the Northern Hemisphere, it is still in Northern Hemisphere. From March till September, it is in Northern Hemisphere. From March till September, there will be summer in Northern Hemisphere. I am talking about Northern Hemisphere, not India. Okay, so obviously, there will be low pressure in Northern Hemisphere. Okay. And high pressure over the southern hemisphere region. Okay, so low pressure, it develops in northwest Indian part. Okay, so this part will have low pressure area. Okay, it's something, it is mentioned that from Peshawar to Lake Baikal. So Lake Baikal and Peshawar, in that part there is low pressure developed in northwest India. Okay, so this part will have low pressure. Now what does this low pressure do? As I have told you, the one of the law of nature, that wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. Okay, so obviously this low pressure, and here there is high pressure in southern hemisphere. Okay, so this low pressure area attracts the wind from this southern hemisphere. Okay, always keep one thing in mind. There will be a some span in our life that we will be empty with the pockets. Okay, so just try to understand one law of the nature. Second law I will like to tell you, will like to share with you people. There will be low pressure, but there is no vacuum anywhere. Check out the place, overall the earth, there is no vacuum. So low pressure may develop, but there is no vacuum. And whenever there is low pressure, the winds blows from high pressure to low pressure. It is going, if your life is going through low pressure, just keep it in mind that there will be high pressure throughout the span. So coming back, so these attracts the southeast trade winds. Now again, if you remember, I have explained during the hot weather season that there are planetary winds. This is northeast, this is southeast, this is southwest, this is northwest. Out of this, I told you these are trade winds. Again, these are easterlies, as E is present here, try to understand. So it is blowing from southeast to northwest region. So here it is said that northwest part of India attracts the southeast trade winds. Okay, before going further, let me clear this board, please. Okay, try to understand that there is low pressure created over this area, Peshawar to Lake Baikal. Okay, this is Peshawar and this is Lake Baikal, Baikal Lake. Okay, this is Peshawar. So here low pressure is developed. Okay, and at the same time there is high pressure in the southern hemisphere. Okay, over Indian Ocean. So this low pressure in northwest India attracts southeast trade winds. Okay, I have missed the Sri Lanka, please ignore that part. Okay, just focus on this part. So here we have southeast trade wind. I have just explained you how the winds are blowing and which are the planetary winds. So once these southeast trade winds are attracted by this low pressure area. I have told you, wherever there is low pressure, the winds are attracted from high pressure to that area. Okay, and winds will blow from high pressure to low pressure. So it started, once it crosses the equator, they changes their direction. Okay, under the Coriolis force. Under the Coriolis force, they change their direction towards southwest. And these southeast trade wind, which are planetary wind, which are present there 24/7, which are present there for 365 days, they suddenly, after changing their direction, become southwest monsoon wind. Okay, now southwest monsoon wind, don't get confused with southwest anti-trade wind. Again, I am repeating. This is southeast trade wind. This is northeast trade wind. This is southwest anti-trade wind. And this is northwest anti-trade wind. So please don't get confused with this wind. These are the planetary winds. It is 24/7 present. This is southwest monsoon wind, which is present during June to September only. So southwest monsoon winds is a seasonal wind, and southwest anti-trade wind is a planetary wind. Okay, keep it in mind. So this southwest monsoon wind, so this southeast trade wind becomes southwest monsoon wind under the Coriolis force, which is given by Farrell's law. It has been given by Farrell's law. Now what is this Farrell's law? So it is simple. If you are standing in northern hemisphere, this is northern hemisphere, this is southern hemisphere. If you are standing in northern hemisphere facing towards North Pole. Okay, if you are standing in northern hemisphere looking towards North Pole, the winds which is blowing from your back will take turn towards your right hand. This is your right hand and this is your left hand. It will turn towards your right. Okay. If you are standing in southern hemisphere pointing towards South Pole. Okay. So the winds coming from your back will turn towards your left. At this time, this become left and this become right. Okay. This is left. This is right. This is left. This is right. Okay. So this is what Farrell's law. This is what Farrell's law. Farrell's give this law and thus this winds become southeast trade winds become southwest monsoon wind. Now there is high pressure in over Indian Ocean. As I have told you, high pressure area develops over Indian Ocean, low pressure over northwest part of India. This southeast trade wind becomes or changes to southwest monsoon wind. As I have explained you, after crossing the equator, this is equator, after crossing the equator due to Coriolis force under Farrell's law, this southeast trade wind changes their direction and becomes southwest monsoon wind. Okay, and they changes their direction between 40 degree to 60 degree east. So between 40 degree to 60 degree east longitude, they changes their direction. Okay, so here there will be 40 degree east longitude. As you know that 68 degree 7 minute, this is the westernmost limit of India and here it is 60 degree, assuming that there is 60 degree, so it is changing at that point. Okay, so now this was about the source, which are the source of southwest monsoon wind. So which wind it is actually? It is actually southeast trade wind, which after crossing the equator changes its direction under the Coriolis force given by Farrell's law to southwest monsoon wind. Okay, simple statement. Now coming to the next point. So now again one more point is that intertropical convergence zone. Again going back, we have planetary winds, northeast trade winds. Okay, I am talking about these only two, southeast trade winds. As they blow over the part, that is, we say it as a tropical. So trade wind, trade wind. Now what is this ITCZ? It becomes ITCZ. Okay, so here along what we say is 0 to 10 degree. This is 0 degree, 10 degree or for sorry 5 degree north and 5 degree south. Okay. So the trade winds, this is northeast trade wind, this is southeast trade wind, it blows over this part, okay, forming ITCZ throughout the earth on the equator, near equator from 5 degree north to 5 degree south, the northeast trade wind and southeast trade wind converge intertropical as there is Tropic of Cancer in the above part and Tropic of Capricorn below this, 23 and half degree north and 23 and half degree south. So Tropic of Cancer intertropical converging. So one from the top, that is northeast trade wind, another from the bottom, that is southeast trade wind, those are converging between the tropics, hence the word is intertropical. As it is converging, the another term is convergence and this becomes a zone. So it is an intertropical convergence zone, okay, forming. Now again coming back, so this intertropical convergence zone, okay, it shifts to 25 degree north, which is at the 5 degree to 5 degree south, 5 degree north to 5 degree south. So this become NITC, North Intertropical Convergence, okay. And this become SITC. So this NITC shifts over the northern part. Okay. NITC, north of the intertropical convergence zone, shift at the 25 degree north. Because here there is 23 and half degree north. So above there, there will be NITC. So I can say that ITCZ is shifting towards this part. And again, what is ITCZ? As this is northeast trade wind, this is southeast trade wind. So this ITCZ is actually a low pressure belt. It is actually a low pressure belt or low pressure zone that shifts from the 5 degree north to 25 degree north. Try to understand. This ITCZ, which is at 5 degree north to 5 degree south, due to the shifting of sun, the position of sun from equator till Tropic of Cancer on 21st June, it is at Tropic of Cancer. So along with the position of the sun, the ITCZ is also moving and its northernmost limit stays on 25 degree north. So NITC is going to stop over 25 degree north. Now coming to the next point, that is westerly jet stream. Now again, as I have explained you, four planetary winds. Which are those? Northeast trade wind, southeast trade wind, northwest anti-trade wind, southwest anti-trade wind. Along with these four, there is one more planetary wind at upper level. Okay, around more than 6 to 8 kilometer at the higher level, there is one more wind. Okay, which is said to be, I can classify it as a into the terms of planetary winds, which blows only in the northern hemisphere, and that is jet stream. Okay. So jet stream, we will see about the jet stream in the coming days. What is exactly jet stream? You just have to keep it in mind that when ITCZ is over the this part between 5 degree north and 5 degree south, at the same time jet stream lies here. First there is jet stream. Jet stream is occupying this part. Okay. When ITCZ will move towards this part, before that the jet stream should shift beyond this Himalaya. So jet stream lies here. Jet stream shifts over the Himalaya or northern part of Himalaya. First jet stream will move towards the Himalaya, northern part of Himalaya. And then afterward, this ITCZ or NITC will take the place of jet stream during June month. Okay. So in June, jet stream is towards the north of Himalaya. And in the June, the ITCZ is placing itself over the Indian part. Okay. So jet stream gives the space to this ITCZ. Okay, jet stream moves towards the north of Himalaya, which was earlier toward the south of Himalaya. Once with the position of sun changes, it is here, jet stream suddenly moves to that part north of the Himalaya, and ITCZ takes place of this jet stream. Try to understand. If you didn't understand, please stop the video, go back and try to understand what I am telling you. Okay. So this westerly jet stream shift towards the north of Himalaya, as I have shown you, and at the same time there is easterly jet stream. So this one was westerly, so now easterly jet stream shift at 15 degree north. Okay, so westerly jet stream is moving from west to east. Now there is another easterly jet stream which takes place. Okay, and it moves from here. So 15 degree north, there is easterly jet stream. Okay, this is westerly jet stream. It is moving from west to east. This is easterly jet stream, which is moving from east to west. Okay, so actually this easterly jet stream, which is flowing over the very much higher level, above 8 kilometer, 9 kilometer, that causes monsoon burst. Now what is monsoon burst? Okay, monsoon burst is nothing but onset of monsoon along with thundering and lightning with heavy downpour of the rain. Okay, there will be violent thundering and lightning. Okay, and there will be rain. Okay, so this is monsoon burst. This easterly jet stream is responsible for monsoon burst. Okay, try to understand. Now which are the dates and where we will have the monsoon, on which that is arrival of monsoon, in which region it arrives. Okay, so it arrives here on 25th May first. Okay, then here on 1st June at Malabar coast, then on 5th June it is approaching to Kanara coast, then around 10th June it reaches to Konkan coast. When it reaches on 1st June at Malabar coast, at the same time it reaches here also. Now this is very much surprising. Why? How it can reaches this part? Okay, I will explain you further. So 1st June here to between 1st June to 5th June here also there will be the thing, and at last it is reaching by 15 September towards the Punjab region. So okay, and throughout the July the monsoon is established over the Indian subcontinent, and it is reaching here where there is low pressure. If you remember, this is the low pressure area. It reaches there by mid September. Okay, so this was about the onset of monsoon. Okay, kindly do like, comment and share the video if you have liked it. Okay, and also subscribe our channel Wisdom Jobs, and like, I will like to tell you, this video is very much helpful for the students who are preparing for 10th level, that is SSC, intermediate level or 12th level or graduation level, and also for various competitive exams. Okay, so thank you and keep tuning the Wisdom Jobs. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. Myself Roopesh Jadhav, I am geography tutor here. Today we are going to see the second part of the southwest monsoon season. If you have not seen my previous video about the rainy season or southwest monsoon season, please go and see it. Afterwards come back to this video again. Okay, and if you have not seen my previous video about the climate regarding hot weather season, cold weather season, then physiographic division, then Himalayan region, North Indian plain, peninsular plateau, coastal area in Ireland. If you are not seen, you have missed a lot. So please go and watch those videos. Also, I will like to tell you that these videos are very much helpful for the students who are preparing for 10th level, for 12th level, or intermediate or graduation level, and also for the students who are preparing for various competitive exams. Okay, so let's start now the second part of the southwest monsoon season. Now, I have told you about the monsoon burst. I told you about the monsoon burst in my previous video, but again I am going to repeat it. What is exactly monsoon burst? This term in terminology always comes. So exactly what does it mean? So it means sudden onset. When the rainy season start, it doesn't give indication. It suddenly starts, there is sudden rain. So there is sudden onset of moisture laden winds. Those winds, if you have seen my previous video, you might be knowing that the southeast trade winds get change after crossing the equator to southwest monsoon wind. So these are those moisture laden winds. They carry moisture from the Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. Okay, so along with violent thunder, so there will be thundering and lightning in the sky, and there will be heavy rain. So that is what monsoon burst. There will be heavy rainfall at one place for continue long period. That is what monsoon burst. Okay, now this monsoon, after the southeast trade winds crosses the equator, it leads to two branches. One branch is Arabian Sea branch, and second branch is that of Bay of Bengal branch. Okay, try to understand how it is going to work. So as I have told you that there will be two branches. Okay, one branch is Arabian Sea branch, so this is Arabian Sea, and second branch is of Bay of Bengal branch, that this is Bay of Bengal. Okay, now first branch, that is Arabian Sea branch, okay, once the southeast trade winds crosses the equator, it leads to the formation of these two branches. So one branch goes like this And another branch goes like this. So this is Bay of Bengal branch and this is Arabian Sea branch. We get maximum rainfall from Arabian Sea branch. Okay, so we get maximum rainfall during rainy season due to this Arabian Sea branch. Okay, so again this Arabian Sea branch is going to split into three different categories. Okay, one Western Ghat branch. Okay, second coast north of Mumbai branch and Saurashtra Peninsula or Kutch branch. So let me show you, this is what Vindhya, this is Vindhya, this is Satpura, this is Western Ghat. Okay, so this branch get bifurcate into three parts. This is Aravali. Okay, now this branch gets split into three parts. First is Western Ghat. So the Western Ghat branch, okay, it goes through this one. So this is Western Ghat branch, which starts from the Kanyakumari till Mumbai or Goa or Konkan coast. Okay, it is covering this Konkan coast, this Kanara coast, and this Malabar coast. Okay, this branch, again, the type of rainfall which receives during this period is that of orographic. I have explained you the type of rainfall. If you remember, I have explained you the orographic type of rainfall, that it is carrying the moisture from the Arabian Sea. This is Western Ghat. Okay, and it is delivering the rain 100 centimeter, 200 centimeter, 300 centimeter at the top. It will give 600 centimeter over Western Ghat. Okay, so as it goes up due to lapse rate, this wind, this moisture carrying wind gets cooled down and they delivered more amount of rainfall as they go up. Okay, Oru means mountain. So Oru means due to mountain, they are yielding too much rainfall in this, as the height of the Western Ghat is 900 to 1200 meter. Okay, so they delivered the rainfall over this Western Ghat up to 600 centimeter at some point, at the highest point, at the topmost point or the top level of the Western Ghat. Okay, then the second branch is coast north of Mumbai. After this, here is Mumbai. This is the A branch. Now coming to the next B branch. Okay, it goes like this. Okay, it is splitting. This is southwest monsoon wind. This is southwest monsoon wind. It splits into B. So it passes here, there is Narmada trough and here there is Son trough. So river Narmada, I have explained you in the drainage system. If you have not watched that video, please go through that video. So Narmada river is flowing to this and Son river is flowing to this direction. So it is again flowing around the Narmada Tapi trough. This leads to this branch yields rainfall to this Ganga plain and over the central part of India. Okay, so central India receives rainfall due to this branch, that is coast north of Mumbai branch. Okay, and the third one is Saurashtra or Peninsula branch, which split into this way, C. So it yields some amount of rainfall over this Saurashtra part or Peninsula. Saurashtra Peninsula is this part, is Saurashtra Peninsula, and Kutch is also there. Okay, so this is Gulf of Kutch. Okay, and it moves parallel to the Aravali. Now this branch again goes back and meet to this Saurashtra branch at Punjab. Okay, now coming to the next branch, that is Bay of Bengal branch. Now this Bay of Bengal branch enters through Bay of Bengal. First it goes to this direction to Myanmar, but here there is again the range, Arkan Yoma range is there. If you know that, I have explained you, it is Andaman and Nicobar is the extension of Arkan Yoma range of Myanmar. So this branch again gets split into two way, one from the south part, this one is the southward. Okay, it is coming from the south direction, and the winds which gets deflected due to this Arkan Yoma and enters from southeast direction. So this is southeast wind and this is south wind. So it is entering West Bengal part from south and southeast direction and not from the southwest. This is southwest. So Bengal is receiving the winds from south and southeast direction. At the same time, in my previous video, I have told you about the onset of monsoon, that it reaches here on 1st June, that is this Arabian Sea branch. At the same time, the another branch reaches here again around 1st to 5 June. As I have told you, I will tell you the reason. So I was not able to conclude the reason in that video. So I am trying to tell you that on 1st June, that it is southwest monsoon wind, Arabian Sea branch entering to this part, Malabar coast, and Bay of Bengal branch reaches to Kolkata by 1st June. Okay, now, so again, after deflected by Arkanyoma range, it turns into southeast wind, okay, southeast monsoon wind type, but it is actually southwest monsoon wind. So, but it is entering in southeast direction, from southeast direction, okay, not from southwest direction. Okay, so this is now this winds again get splitted. Okay, this winds again split as there is Himalaya present here. So under the influence of Himalaya, it splits over first again under the influence of Himalaya and low pressure area. Obviously here, if you remember, I have told in my previous video that low pressure developed between Peshawar and Lake Baikal, that is northwest part of India. So it is moving over the Ganga plain and another split and moves towards the Brahmaputra valley. Okay, now again this wind, that is this south and southeaster southeaster direction winds, after splitting into two direction, one moves to this northwest part, that is over Ganga. It is again going and meeting with these two branches. Earlier we have seen that Saurashtra and Peninsular branch, and the second one is from north coast of Mumbai, which receives. So there is one branch, this one, second branch, this one, and third one from this. Okay, so this is going to meet the Punjab plain. Now about this branch. So here there is Shivalik. Here there is Garo, Khasi, Jaintia. Here there is Purvanchal. So the wind get trapped between these hills. Okay. And there is somewhat this funnel shaped form, and it pour the rain into that particular area. So hence, that's why here on Garo Hill, okay, Garo and Khasi, Garo Khasi, there is the Monsoon Ram, the place Monsoon Ram receives the highest amount of rainfall in the world. It is said to be the wettest place in the world. First one is Monsoon Ram and second one is Cherrapunji. Both are located over this Khasi Hill. Okay, so Garo, Khasi and Jaintia, and this one is Purvanchal. So this part receive highest amount of rainfall, more than 1000 centimeter of rainfall is received by this two places. Okay, so but let me tell you, Mumbai from 2005 onwards is receiving more rainfall than Monsoon Ram and Cherrapunji. Okay, but as I have told you in the very starting, in the climate, that any place to record the highest amount of rainfall, it should receive that amount of rainfall for consequently 30 to 35 years. So there must be high amount of rainfall for continuously 30 to 35 years, then and only then that place will be coming to overtake the Monsoon Ram. So Mumbai will have to receive 30 to 35 years highest amount of rainfall, then only in books it will be there that Mumbai is the highest wettest place in the world. But right now the wettest place is Monsoon Ram. Okay, and that too due to this this wind. Okay, this Bay of Bengal branch which split there. Now another term is there about that, that is what we say, monsoon trough. You might have heard about this. So now what is the monsoon trough? It is a path of tropical depression. Now, during this season, the tropical depression originates in Bay of Bengal. Okay. So, there is tropical cyclone originating in Bay of Bengal. Okay, determining by the position of ITCZ. As you remember in my previous video, I have told you that ITCZ is shifting over 25 degree north. Okay, NITC shift towards 25 degree north. So, during this period from Delhi to Kharagpur, the monsoon trough form. Okay. And it is somewhat changing its position. Now, what is this monsoon trough? It is the path of this tropical cyclone. So, it is the path of this tropical depression originating in Bay of Bengal, which determined the position of ITCZ. Okay. It is determined by the position of ITCZ. There will be shifting of ITCZ and movement of this monsoon trough. Okay. It will be going like this. Now, why there are breaks in monsoon? So, what does the breaks in monsoon means? It simply means there will be no rain. Okay. As we know that there will be rain for continuously 2 weeks and suddenly there will be no rain for 1 week or 2 weeks or more than 2 weeks. So, that is said to be break in monsoon or monsoon break. Okay. So, it will be for 2 weeks. It may be for 1 week in different region. Now, what is the causes of having these breaks in different region? Okay. So, the very first is this North India. North India will have less amount of rainfall or no rainfall as the rain bearing storm, that is these cyclones, tropical depression. Okay. Not very frequent along the monsoon trough. Okay. So, this cyclone or tropical depression, those occupying this path between Delhi to Kharagpur, so they are not approaching there. Okay, this will lead to no rain in that region or break in monsoon. Another thing is position of ITCZ. As I have told you, the position of ITCZ must be over the 25 degree north. Okay, and again ITCZ is low pressure belt, so it will attract the winds from the high pressure area, that is Indian Ocean. If it is not shifted properly to that part, so North India will receive no rainfall. Okay, again you might be knowing that at 15 degree north there is easterly jet stream, so this part will have rainfall due to presence of easterly jet stream. But ITCZ should shift towards North India at 25 degree north, then and only then Northern India will receive the rainfall. Now, coming to the next third one, that is West Coast. If in any case this monsoon winds, if started blowing parallel to this West Coast, so this will also remain dry. Okay, so as you might be knowing, when the Bay of Bengal branch, which goes parallel to this eastern ghat, so this eastern coastal plain also remain dry because there is this Bay of Bengal branch moves parallel to eastern coastal plain. Similarly, here is Aravali, so the winds are blowing parallel to Aravali. Hence, there will be no rain or very less amount of rainfall. And the Tamil Nadu coast will receive no rain, as I have told you. Okay, this Bay of Bengal branch is moving parallel to the eastern coast. So, eastern coast will remain mostly dry, but some part will receive the rainfall due to this tropical depression. Okay, so like Orissa and Andhra Pradesh, some part in West Bengal, they will receive rainfall due to this tropical depression. Okay, now let me tell you, if you understood that which part of India receives or doesn't receive the rainfall, we will see that, we will try to correlate Okay, so firstly, Rajasthan, it doesn't receive rainfall because the winds are blowing parallel to it. Okay, so very less amount of rainfall, less than 25 centimeter or between 25 to 50 centimeter, because it is blowing parallel. Okay, secondly, this Tamil Nadu coast, it doesn't receive rainfall because Bay of Bengal branch moves parallel to the Tamil Nadu coast. Thirdly, this part will have very less amount of rainfall, less than 20 or 25 centimeter. Okay, because the Himalaya is obstructing the southwest monsoon wind to go to that side. Okay, so try to understand which part doesn't receive. I am telling about those area which will receive very less rainfall or didn't receive any amount of rainfall. Firstly, the Rajasthan. Secondly, the Tamil Nadu coast. Now, this, when the southwest monsoon wind goes, so in that case, this Tamil Nadu coast lies in rain shadow area. Okay, again, this is windward side, this is leeward side. This receive many plenty amount of rainfall, this will receive no rainfall. So Tamil Nadu coast lies in this part. Okay, and secondly, the Bay of Bengal branch goes parallel to the Tamil Nadu coast. Okay, then Ladakh part also receive very less amount or no rainfall because the Himalaya is obstructing the winds to go beyond that region. Okay, and certain some part here also which receive very less amount of rainfall or no rainfall. So this was all about the approaches, various branches of southwest monsoon wind. If you like it, please do like, comment and share the video to your friends. If you have not subscribed my videos till now, so please do subscribe Wisdom Jobs. Okay, and I am very much thankful to you. Please give comment in your comment box. If you place it, I will improve myself to give you more information and it will boost us. Okay, thank you very much. Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Job. This is Roopesh Jadhav again. Here I am with another topic on geography that is related to climate. Okay, and many people face the problem that exactly what is that? We are talking about Coriolis force. Okay, and before going for that, I will like to tell you, please go through my videos on climate. Various seasons are there. Okay, Indian monsoon, you go through southwest monsoon season, you go through northeast monsoon season video. Okay, all those are related to this topic. Okay, if you don't understand what is exactly happening here, you have to refer that video. Okay, so without wasting our time, let's go and start for our topic, today's topic. But before that, I will like to tell you, please give like, comment and share my videos to your friends and also subscribe my channel Wisdom Jobs. Okay, so let's start. My today's question is, which of the following forces is responsible for the deflection of winds, the deflection of winds from its normal path? Okay, now we know that this is equator and this is the southeast trade wind. Okay, this is southeast trade wind at 0 degree equator. Okay, they deflect from its normal path. Their normal path is that southeast trade wind blows from southeast direction towards northwest. If we check out, we'll came to know that this is southeast trade wind, this is north, this is south, this is east and this is west. So it is blowing from southeast direction towards northwest, but it gets deflect from its normal path. This should be its normal path. It should blow from southeast towards northwest, but after crossing the equator, the question is with related to equator, okay, which is not mentioned there. Okay, after crossing the equator, they deflect towards their other two others direction, that is, it becomes southwest. Now, which is that force which deflect this wind? On other hand, there is this wind, that is northeast trade wind. Okay, it should blow in this direction. Okay, northeast trade wind should blows towards southwest direction. Okay, here it is. But after crossing equator, it changes its direction and it deflects towards this side, that it becomes southeast. Okay, so it starts blowing towards southeast. Now, which is that force which results in the deflection of these winds? Okay, normal path, is it centripetal force? Now, you might be knowing about centripetal and centrifugal force. Okay, that which is directing towards the center, it is said to be centripetal force. Okay, and that which is going out of the center, outward of the center, it is said to be centrifugal force. Is it so? Do you think that it is so? No, it doesn't seem that it is concentrating on one point. Okay, it is not going inward side, as it is deflecting one. Is it Coriolis force? Now, what is this Coriolis force? Or is it some type of applied force? Do you think it is an applied force? It might be possible that something is there which is diverting this southeast trade winds and make it it changes direction as southwest. Is there something applied force? Is there something applied force which makes northeast trade wind to deflect in southeast direction? Is it some applied force there? That force is applied and hence they are changing their direction. Okay, or is it gravitational force? What do you think? What should it be? Okay, now let's check out. The answer is Coriolis force. Here it is given, Coriolis force. It is said to be the answer. Okay, now Coriolis force is the force by which objects deflects in the right. Now let me rub it again. Coriolis force is the force by which objects deflect. It deflects, or sorry, it should be deflect towards right in the northern hemisphere and towards left in the southern hemisphere. That is, there is Coriolis. This force is Coriolis force. Right in northern hemisphere and left in southern hemisphere. Okay. Now how? Check out. This is southeast trade wind blowing from southeast direction towards northwest. It is blowing towards northwest, but due to Coriolis force, there is some force here acting. Okay, don't consider it as a cyclone. Like gear, gear boxes have gears, in that way those are there. It deflects it towards its right. Okay, so this is, it deflects towards right in northern hemisphere. This is northern hemisphere and this is what? Southern hemisphere. Okay, in this way, this southeast trade wind becomes southwest monsoon wind during southwest monsoon season. So you have to refer the video of southwest monsoon season. Okay, now and in towards left in the southern hemisphere, for this you have to refer the video southwest monsoon season. Okay, and the second point is, it towards left in the southern hemisphere. This is northeast trade wind. It is deflecting towards its left. Okay, and it becomes southeast. Okay, so it becomes southeast. So here it is deflecting at, in southern hemisphere it is deflecting at left, and in northern hemisphere it is deflecting at right hand. You can check out. Okay, so now how you say that in both case it is deflecting towards right? It is not so. You say here, you will agree that yes, it is blowing in this direction and turning towards right hand. So it is right here, but regarding this point you will say it is not left hand, it is again right. So it is not so. Let's tell me you, this concept is given by Farrell's law. Now, as per Farrell's law, the wind which is blowing in the northern hemisphere will deflect towards right in northern hemisphere and it will deflect towards left in the southern hemisphere. Now, again, I will tell you, for this, for left deflection of the northeast trade wind and becoming southeast, you have to go through northeast monsoon season or winter season video. Okay. And for this, you have to go southwest monsoon season video. Okay, please refer those video so that you will understand. Now, what is the Farrell's law? As per Farrell's law, if a person is standing in northern hemisphere, okay, if he is standing in northern hemisphere, the wind which is blowing from its back and he is pointing, he is looking at north pole, he is looking towards North Pole, the wind which is coming from its back will deflect on its right. This becomes his right because he is looking at that side. Like me, I am looking now at that side. So this is my right, okay, and this is his left, right? So it is the south east trade winds which blows from its back gets turned towards its right and becomes southwest monsoon wind. It deflects towards the right, okay, if the person is looking at North Pole. This is what the concept for Northern Hemisphere. Now, if the same person is standing in Southern Hemisphere but looking towards South Pole. Now, here I have shown his eyes, okay. Here it is his hair. He is looking towards that side. Here, if the person is looking towards South Pole, then the wind which blows from its back will turn to its left. Okay. Now, if I am standing like this, this is my left. Okay. And if I am standing like this, it is my right. So, if I am standing like this and this is the South Pole, okay, it is turning to my left hand and this becomes right. So, this was I was saying that you may consider that in both cases, it is deflecting. This is northeast trade wind. Here it is deflecting towards right and here it is deflecting towards left. Okay. So, try to understand. Otherwise, you will consider that in both hemisphere, it is deflecting towards right only. It is not so. In southern hemisphere, it is deflecting on my left hand because I am facing towards the South Pole. If I am facing towards the North Pole, it is deflecting on my right hand. So, this is the simple concept of Farrell's law. Okay. Farrell's has given this law and the force which is responsible for the deflection of the winds, those are said to be Coriolis force. Okay. So, hope my this video have clear your idea about the Coriolis force, Farrell's law and deflection of winds all over the globe. Okay. So, please understand that the Farrell's law talks about Coriolis force. Okay. And the force which is resulting in the deflection of the wind is Coriolis force and that is given by a statement, that is by a law which is given by Farrell. Okay. So, dear friends, hope this video might helpful to you and it have clear your doubts about the Coriolis force, deflection of wind and Farrell's law. So, isi baat pe, please give like, comment and share my video to your friends and your WhatsApp group or your Facebook, okay, or Insta, and please subscribe my channel Wisdom Jobs. Thank you.